But I'm showing you in the third century, all right? The third century right here. That's what was written. So it wasn't Yahweh, all right? Right. Matter of fact, when you go through this, you understand?
We got his name.
Huh?
We got his name.
Okay.
Now, when we're using his name, right?
Right.
In the proper context of today's structure, when we're calling upon one's name, that means that we're calling upon their dictate, we're calling upon their tenets, which is why we dress a certain way, we move a certain way, we speak a certain language. Now, the reason that it was taken from us in the first place is because we hadn't been protecting it. We stopped protecting our culture, and our culture was taken from us.
I can agree with that.
Okay. Now here, the way we protecting the culture is by propagating it. What I'm saying is, if there was a time where Donald Trump got elected, and he says, Hebrew niggers can't be on the corner no more. Wouldn't you have been like, Dad, yo, when Lord Murk-El came through and told me to incorporate before he was, man, because I would have had a preventive measure that would have stated that according to my First Amendment secured right, not given, but my right to secure, the state can't abrogate my expression of religion. And so he might say, well, anybody caught walking around with tassels, they have to have a star on their chest and get sent somewhere. Wouldn't you like to have already had, like, not waiting on no European, like, I'm gonna call police if he does that. Like, no, we already have an office where if they get bucked, I'm gonna knock on your door and be like, yo, they just tried to oppress me. They said that they saw my tassels. They wanna do something to me. And there's some type of legal recourse where, okay, well, now you owe so-and-so millions. You know, you're anti-Semitic.
I get what you're saying. But here's the thing, though. It's 2 points to this, too. He could pass a law like that. And I'm gonna be like, okay, we already know it's prophesied in the Bible how it's gonna be a famine of the word in the land. That's clear. That's cut. All right. Okay. There's gonna be a famine of the word in the land, so people not really gonna be out there teaching like they're supposed to.
They're also, not now. That's right.
All right. And also, I know how it's already prophesied that they're gonna be giving us up to authorities to be killed in those days and put in prison. That's prophesied about the disciples or the people that's out teaching this book. However, let's go to the other side of it. Even if I got the laws, okay, Donald Trump, I got laws that's protecting me. I can be out here street teaching. Okay, that's cool. You got laws. Stand out here street teaching. Now I'm gonna tell whoever, the high authorities, yo, we gonna go seek these people out. We gonna go to their house, we gonna kill them all so they won't be out there street teaching. So, military still is of effect when it comes to even being out here, even if we got certain paperwork. Why? Because they can still kill us. Because we don't have no military. We don't have no army to protect ourselves.
And so you need
money. Doesn't even matter, does it?
But you do have an army to protect yourself.
And what is that?
Everybody, you see all these men right here? I'm not gonna speak for all of y'all, man, take it personal, but none of y'all look soft except for maybe young, you know what I'm saying? But all of y'all look like real strong men that don't look soft, y'all don't look like y'all getting punked in jail. So I don't see how some European who got here yesterday, okay, is gonna outsmart you and outman you and outmaneuver you, because if you know that they're gonna be seeking you for being part of the 5% poor righteous teachers who do not believe in the teachings of the 10%, you all wise, you should already have. You should already be at the door like this in the name of Yahaya.
Alright, now. That's good and cool. Now, we all seen the movie Straight Outta Compton, right?
No. Nobody? I was too busy teaching.
All right, too busy teaching. Who seen the movie Straight Outta Compton?
It's all right, raise your hand, man.
Yeah, who seen the movie Straight Outta Compton? You say you did?
Hold on,
you saw it? If anybody remembers the part in the beginning, when Eazy-E, he went to the drug dealer's house, right? He went to the drug dealer's house, tried to exchange some drugs. The police that came around the corner, they didn't just show up as men. They had a big army tank with a whole thing to knock down the whole household. So you can have all the guns, but the fact of the matter is, we still don't have the technology like they have it. We just don't. So we're still subject to them. Why? They have the arsenal. They have the military might. So no matter how many things we can gather up, guns, you understand?
Because the power of the Most High won't allow them. See, now I could get on you. I can get like
but
that
the power
too.
Of the Most High said that we were going to go through certain things, so it wouldn't even put us in that thing in the first place.
Well, if we're going to go through things, I know this cracking out about to come knock on my door with no bulldog, because guess what? I'm finna, you see, when I'm in preventive vision, see him coming, I'll be at the other house. And I'll be waiting for him, because you see, Eazy-E, what he was doing, he was dealing drugs. He wasn't studying every day. You see, we can't place ourselves in the situations of the average Asiatic, the average so-called black, because we standing here, we not them. We have lessons. We know the prophecy. We know there's going to be a famine on the land. There was already multiple famines on the land. I'm not waiting for the next one. That's why I'm out here now.
Yeah, let me get something for you though, brother. Because this is the thing right here. The weapons of our warfare, we got to remember, they're not carnal. See, that's why we're, you know, exactly. So no matter how much like carnality we try to, you know, hold the, and I agree with you to some degree, you understand? Because yes, do we want to have something to protect ourselves? Of course we do. But it won't be enough to say, to start dictating what the so-called white man, what he has put on this earth, with the police, with the army, with the military. It's not at that level, you understand? And now once we make it carnal, man, we're going to defend ourselves. We're going to get the truth. Let's fight back at him. Now we've made it a carnal situation.
You know what? Understand? Well, before we get to a carnal situation, something maybe we should start with this.
Right? Well, yeah. Let me write my content. We're going to write our content down. That's number one. All right? I want to build some more with them, but got it? Got it? Cool. Murk-El. All right, because, you know, I seen the bills you did with Polite and Sardinella and all them, you know what I'm saying?
Feel free to sign my joint, too. You know what I'm saying? Please reach out to me. This is what I do for real. Don't all jump at once.
Go ahead.
There's a lot of different things. You won't talk about a lot. But you know what you all was doing earlier? You was telling black folks about the devastation that's going to come on them in America.
Exactly.
I think you need to get back in there. It's personal. Because everybody ain't going to agree with you.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? But everybody can relate to the devastation that's going to come on our people in some months, years to come. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
That's what you need to get back on.
For though we walk in the flesh, go ahead.
We do not war after the flesh.
Go ahead.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Right, the weapons of our warfare, what's going on in this life, it's not carnal though, you understand? So I understand what you, because okay, I know people have brought this up to you before. Black Wall Street. Now that's a perfect example of what you're talking about now. Minus the religion part, minus the community that we established.
And the military,
right? Black Wall Street. So you are okay. So now, what would your response be to Black Wall Street? Because the reason why it's not thriving,
the FOI.
It's the FOI.
If they would have had a military, they'd have been all right. Some type of military structure. We as people got to stop being so soft and thinking that we're gonna do something and God got us. Because guess what? If I go set up shop on 120th, better. If I go set up shop on 116th Street. Now I'm talking about it, and I'm saying God got me, it's not going damn. But if I set up on 116th and I got that ratchet on me, there's a good chance I'm going to be on 115th a little bit longer.
You don't have to be on 115th at all.
Here's what I'm saying, some of us don't got a choice.
So he can be able to lead you to another
place. Some of us don't got a choice. Some of us already there, Mo. Know what I'm saying?
There's some of us right now,
when they walk past here, they already been gangbanging 10, 12 years. They don't got time for that.
Let me say this, we have to be a lot more smarter in our approach when we're doing things, brother. Listen to me. I understand what we all trying to do and get knowledge out, but we got to understand that we have to be a lot more smarter in our approach when we're doing, because we have deceived a lot of people with different these negativism things. But let me say this to y'all.
You've been doing a lot of talking, man.
Yeah, but you know what?
You keep running away, you coming back.
Deuteronomy 28:46.
Go ahead.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
They shall be upon thee. These curses shall be upon thee for a sign and a wonder. Go ahead.
And upon thy seed forever.
Upon thy seed forever. All right, these curses. Let's read some of the curses. Give me verse 47.
Hey, I enjoyed y'all. Listen.
Deuteronomy 28:47. Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyness and with gladness of heart for the abundance of all things. Therefore shall thy serve thy enemies.
Shall you do what?
Therefore shall thou serve thy enemies.
So the question is, how can we reverse this curse? Because we are serving our enemies.
Stop getting a job. Now I'm playing.
Yeah. How we gonna do this?
Becoming self-sufficient and autonomous by creating our own social, economic, and political platforms.
Okay, well. off. That's not particularly what the Bible said, but if it has a curse that what we're going through, we got to find out how we got in this position, all right? Go ahead, read.
Therefore shall thou serve thy enemy, which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger and in thirst.
In hunger and in thirst. Go ahead.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness.
And in want of all things.
So it's a curse that we under. I mean, I don't, you know, see, that's why I was asking, like, we coming from two different perspectives, you understand? Because I understand it's a spiritual mechanism that's prohibiting us from getting the way you're trying to get us to. I understand what you're going, and it's, listen, if we was in a whole other world and this wasn't, hey, I'd be all down for it, man. I would be all down for it, because I'm agreeing with what you trying to establish.
Right.
I just don't agree that it should be here, and I agree that it should be at a later date when we have our true leader.
I'm not.
So but that's a whole other topic.
I'm not going front. I feel at home here. I don't feel like I came from Africa or South America. I feel at home here.
Of course you did. You're born.
So I'm saying, like,
you're going to feel that way.
So, you know, it's like anything that I want to establish, even here, I'm in Chicago right now, I feel like I need to get back to Harlem and do something. That's what I'm saying. I need to. So that being said, like, and the youth that I have too, I don't want to wait till later, because if I have children, I'm not trying to wait till like 15, 17, and I'm telling them, yo, you know, wait a little longer. We're not getting established for them here. Although the warfare not carnal, if you got locked up tomorrow for something you ain't do, and you had the ability to call me because you knew that I would know something in the law, like, for example, when they stopped you, it was Act of an Amendment 4 warrant signed by our Article 3 judge, particularly describing the person's place to be searched and seized in accordance with the 4th Amendment. Now I'm saying, then people be like, oh snap, you know what? I'm gonna go call Lord, because you don't call Lord Murk-El, you know that. Matter of fact, all of y'all know that. After a while, them boys start coming around like, nah, son, because if I hop out on him, he gonna spit that. I'm saying, I'm gonna have a $1.5 million suit on my case. You see, they could do things like us, like what they did to Freddie Gray. When you keep getting locked up, now you got a suit. And they're like, oh, he's just another nigga with a suit. But now it's 50 of y'all.
Right? Or you can say that. And then when you asleep at night and nobody is around you, your brother's not here to protect you, they can come in secretly and come and take you out.
That's what you're hired for, G. You can't just be all corner and then lose faith in one. If I'm out here and I'm in the street where you're hired when I'm in the sleep, if I'm supposed to go that night, and that's what and the Lord the Most High allowed that, and that's what it is. But if the Lord, but if the Most High allows me to take 1465, because this feels like it's being gentrified. This feels like my people used to be here, and now Europeans just started moving in. Am I right?
No, that's right.
Okay, because I feel like my people are really, like, they were here, and I just feel like they don't.
Yeah, feel like a Harlem vibe, don't
they? Like, they're getting used to us still.
Yeah,
they're
read,
still
read.
Getting used
hey,
to us.
I'm finna show you.
Therefore shall thy serve thy enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger and in thirst and in naked of all things, until he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck, until he have destroyed thee.
Really, the thing is that we're destroyed. I mean, mentally and physically, we're kind of at the level now where the only, because really we're dealing with solutions right now.
Yeah.
That's the overall goal of what we, you know, what we both doing is we're trying to find solutions. We already know what the state we are.
While staying in our paradigm.
Yeah, while staying in our, we're trying to find solutions. So no matter the history that we going to, no matter, you know, what we doing or whatever, we're trying to find solutions. So our solutions might just be different. And that's, you know, that's fine, because I want you to continue what you're doing, you understand? All I can do is tell you is that I'm going to continue with the solutions that God said to do. See, he didn't, it didn't really say get, feel comfortable and get established here, you understand? This was here for punishment for us in the beginning. That's what this America is for.
So I know. The people or the place.
The place. It was set up for punishment for us, though. That's the only reason why we over here.
But we were here before the punishment.
Right. Some people of our people was over there.
I definitely was. I feel no ties to Africa whatsoever.
But we can prove that we, the first people that got over here was of our people. We can prove that in the Bible. But we went off. Why? Because the laws we didn't keep. They sent, I mean, the Most High put a spirit. I know we be getting flack for that, putting a spirit on somebody. what sent a spirit on the
spirit
European to come over here and take us down. You understand? Then they brought us over here in slave ships. We agree with all that.
I don't.
But the
original. In fact, I disagree that the European could put any of us in slavery. Matter of fact, it is my contention that the European is 100% weak and wicked and will not keep and obey the laws of Islam because his ways and actions are like a snake of the grafted type, which is why Muhammad knew that he could not reform the devil so that he had to murder them. In fact, all Muslims will murder the devil because they know he is a snake, and also if he be allowed to live, he will stink someone else. So I find it impossible that some European devil came through and beat me up. In the wintertime? It wasn't in summer.
Okay, but I'm saying, you said a European devil came and beat you up, right?
No, I'm saying it's impossible.
It's impossible,
beat
right?
Me up.
Now,
impossible.
But here, but what I'm saying is that...
Mathematically unequivocal.
But they're doing it all the time.
Nah, God, where? Show me.
What you mean?
Show
so
me.
What happened in Iraq? They went over there in Iraq and took down the Islam. They're not in Africa.
That was us, B. That was us, B. Those weren't no European. That was us over there. When they be coming back to the hood, they be messed up. B, they be over here with the switch doing the Will Smith switch.
But you're just making it sound like all of the army is us, though.
Mostly. Well, we're most of the world, so we compose most of everything, except the homosexual community. That's all Europeans.
Okay.
They got it.
But now, it's a lot.
Word.
You know, it's a lot Europeans, though. They go over there to war, and they take down. I've seen a lot come back.
They be officers. You know why they be coming back? Because they don't be in the fight. That be us. We don't be coming back. They be end up. When I was in the South B, and he was trying to have us up in the recruitment. You know how they recruited us? They used to say, "Yo, as long as you get good grades, we gonna have you in a nice air conditioned room. You gonna be like 03, 04. You gonna get like 3,000 or so and so. It's really 1,700. You know what I'm saying? And they send you out there, and you playing Xbox. We're Asian. You playing Xbox.
So now we're in the military right now. Why can't them as military overcome the, since it's most of us, right?
Mentally.
We could just turn, exactly, the mentality, right? The mentality.
Not back enough of us is in the military.
Back to the scriptures, the mentality. So, I mean, you're going back to the points of the scriptures here.
Okay. You can't escape the scriptures.
You can't escape it, man.
All I'm saying is, but let's build upon it. We have the scriptures. Okay, yo, let's get a building. Why are we on the, yo, let's get a building. All right, yo, listen, man. Let's get this one. And that one, too. And that one. Let's start kicking crackers out of here.
And then what?
And then we kick more crackers out of more places until we get back the entire country. Then we go to Mexico. Then we go to Canada. Then what? Then we go to Africa. And then what? Then we go to Europe again. And then what? Then we go to Asia.
I got a word for it.
I get bored.
I know. I got a word for it.
I'm getting bored.
Delusions of grandeur.
Who coming with me, man?
That's the word I can pull out there. Delusions of grandeur.
But we've done it already. And it's in our historical accounts that the Moorish nation referred to as Negroes ruled the world and the seven seas for 1,196 years.
And then what happened? Why did he fall off?
The Anglo-Dutch German powers that be that we had created from the 12 signs of the Zodiac, Yucatan Peninsula University, right? Where we manufacture the devil because he's not real, human. I feel you because y'all talking about we brothers and all that. I don't feel like that, but that's what's up. All I'm saying is when we manufactured the devil, you know what I'm saying? And he was coming up north from the south. We had started teaching those sciences while we was fighting each other. And due to us fighting each other, enslaving each other, chasing after the gods of Europe from whom we knew nothing, we started to fall. Because we didn't keep the commandments of the Most High. Love your neighbor as you love yourself.
All right, so it still goes back to the commandments then.
I'm not trying to escape the Bible. I'm saying let's build on it. Let's take this building. If you don't want to take the rest of the buildings, fine. I'll keep my buildings and my delusions of grandeur. You can just keep this one. Let's take one.
You don't mind me asking, how many buildings do you have right now?
Right now, zero. You know why? Because I have nobody behind me. You know why? Because people be like, yo, son. Oh, no, son. This cracker got guns, B. And I be like, yo, son. But this cracker got books. And we got books. Matter of fact, we made books. Matter of fact, we taught them how to write and read. Why don't we use these books and apply the knowledge that we have so that we can start to rule again? I don't know, B.
But they saying I don't know. See, I know why.
Denmark.
I know why.
But you're not doing it still.
But
you are doing it, actually.
Yeah, right.
Because while we out here, although we out here building on solutions, there's thousands of other Israelites and Moors who's not.
You're absolutely right.
So it starts with getting this over here and over here, and you get that out there, and other people see it.
Go ahead.
And then he starts talking.
You all talk on the second exodus that's going to take place. The second exodus, Isaiah 30.
Second exodus. But that second exodus is actually not really referring to America per se as a mass people. because everybody's not going to get Exodus out of here. Matter of fact, everybody doesn't deserve to leave here. A lot of our people need to be destroyed. You understand? I mean, I'm just being honest. Exactly. So I don't even want to mass Exodus because there's going to be a lot of confusion wherever we go. You understand? So, but that Exodus, you know, and that Exodus you're talking about is pretty much talking about the wilderness. When we going to get reaped up, you understand? We're
going to
be placed in the wilderness. Exactly. America will already be destroyed by this point, though.
Okay.
You understand? That's what we teach and what we believe. According to the scriptures. You understand? Yeah, so a second Exodus is not really, that's not going to happen here. Now, there will be certain people to leave this place, you understand? Like the scriptures talk about, certain people will flee, certain people will escape. But a mass exodus, that's not going to happen, you understand, according to scripture. Matter of fact, let's read it.
What are you talking about? Isaiah 30, the whole 30. Chapter.
Yeah, Isaiah 30, read that. Give me my
leaving up out of here.
You get it.
Talking about the people. You
what's
know,
your name, by the way, man?
I'm Javette.
JaVale?
King.
JaVette. Nice to meet you, man. Lamont.
Okay, man.
Just get on Isaiah 30.
I do a heavy line upon line.
Isaiah 30. Yes, you say you do
I
what?
I do heavy line upon line.
Okay, so, okay. No problem.
Just I don't follow a lot of the dress ordinances and borders and
garments. Right.
There's a time for that. When you come in the rod and under the bottom.
No, you're absolutely right, man. Yes, sir. You're absolutely right. You can see
right now you're talking about we're different. After the transgressions being blotted in Isaiah 1 and 16 dealing
Isaiah
with
Isaiah 30. Let's read that. So the whole Isaiah 30, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's read that right quick.
Talking about hearing his voice in the mountain and everything.
Yep. Again. Well, hold on. What part in particular? Because that is a long chapter.
I know. When you're getting into like the verse 15, where he says, "In returning and rest shall you be saved." Once you get to that point, he's from 7 through 15 is a real good description of us today and the situation that we're in today, and talking about how we're going to be trusting in Pharaoh
and
the shadow of Egypt.
Read that verse.
It's just good. It's just good.
Verse 15.
For thus saith the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, in returning and rest shall you be saved.
In returning and rest shall you be saved. So how do we have to return first, though?
You have to come back. I'm looking at Isaiah 1 and 16 where he says, wash ye, make ye clean. Because from 9 through like 15, he's talking about do away with the Sabbath, your new moons, the solemn assembly, the feast, all of that. It's a stench to me because your hands are full of blood. He's describing a situation where Israel don't know. When you're starting off in verse 2 or 3, he says, Israel, my people, I raised them up. The ox knows its owner. The ass knows its master's crib. He's making that parallel to say, we don't know who we belong to, and we don't know where we're from. And he says, this people, they got a stench from, you know, the head, you know, all the way through the whole body. And that coming back to him is all about the ordinances that he gave to Moses, which right now is not in effect because we don't even understand and know who we are. At what time does that apply? Because Babylon, they knew who they were under that empire, under the first persecution. They knew who they were under the Medo-Persian, Darius, Cyrus, Artaxerxes. Under the Greek Empire, we knew who we were. Under the Roman Empire, we knew who we were.
Well, certain people did. Let me hit you to something. The Greek Empire, a lot of our people, that's when they started to lose their culture. You understand? You know, when we read about an apocrypha for the Maccabees, they started, why? Because you couldn't pronounce you as a Jew anymore. And they start killing us.
The language is getting watered down through every captivity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So during that time, when you're going to teach your children, like, listen, you got to do what Master say. You understand? Matter of fact, you're not even a Jew no more. You're a Greek. All right? Start giving them that identity. We can read about that in the Maccabees. Exactly. But to your original point, the returning, you know, the first returning has to be is spiritually. That's number one. You understand? We both agree there. The second returning is that those who have returned spiritually and are willing to humble themselves, those will be the ones returning. You understand? When we believe in the Messiah. You believe in the Messiah, right? Ah, okay. Well, yeah, he don't believe.
Well, you do. Let's take your time on it because I want you to run.
All right,
I do the first second command. I was Pentecostal, speaking tongues.
Right.
And then I went to different camps, but I hit a number of different situations. But when I hit the first, second commandment, don't have any gods before me. Don't make any graven image of anything, whether it's in the heaven, on the earth, or in the waters. Right. So nothing. Don't make nothing in His image. And then when you hit Deuteronomy 4:15, Moses said, "Take good heed that you that when." that when I spoke to you from Horeb out of the fire, that you saw no manner of similitude when I spoke to you from Horeb out of the fire. Verse 16, lest you corrupt yourselves and make you an image, the likeness of what? Male or female. So the Father said, don't liken him to what? Male or female. Fish in the sea, birds in the air, beasts that creep up. What is Jesus? Now, that's, I'm just saying, I'm just hitting some good points to say.
But still said image, though, right?
Don't make the Most High into what? Anything in His creation.
You didn't make Him into anything. You didn't, I mean, okay, well, I don't know. That's what I'm saying. Like, we're not dealing with, like, images or visuals.
I got you. I'm feeling
we're dealing with a certain man that walked and became a sacrifice because that's what Israel required.
Which?
That's it.
Well, if you, let's say that doesn't come up right there, you say, okay, well, let's go to Isaiah 43, 10 and 11. Ye are my witnesses, as I told you before, there's no God before me formed, neither will there be any after me formed.
Okay.
I am the Most High. And what they say, where they say Messiah said that? He said that where? On the right hand side, the Most High says, I am the Most High, and besides me, there is no Savior.
Now, that's a good question. Now, when it said that, it said, the word that was used there was God, right?
Mm-hmm.
God said, right?
I'm the Creator.
Yeah.
I'm the Creator.
Now, do you know the Hebrew word for that word God?
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
The Hebrew word, go ahead.
I know the
pictorial letters.
The God, the word, the first and third letters, it said, I sit alone. Well, God, you know, it's only me, right? Now, the word God right there in the Hebrew is Alahayim, all right? Do you know what Alahayim means?
Go ahead.
Powers, plural.
Okay.
Why? Because in the beginning.
The sons of the Most High?
You said what?
The sons of the Most High.
Right, no, well, we're going to get that. Give me 2 Peter 3 and 8.
You're doing the New Testament.
Yeah.
I can't.
Come on, man.
Alahayim.
That means
power.
Is that like Elohim?
I'm just reading something out of the New Testament, but what I'm trying to tell you is that male and female created He them. It tells you throughout the scriptures that there's always been the Most High, the right hand has always been the other power, which is who people call Christ. The other side of it is the Holy Spirit, which is a feminine spirit, all right? Those are the three that bear record in heaven. The Holy Spirit is a feminine spirit. That's why male and female created He them. That's the image. All right? You have a man, you have a woman, you have a son.